One of the greatest guards in his era, second in Cincinnati career scoring behind only Oscar Robertson, Associated Press All-American and a two-time Conference USA Player of the Year. This guy was a special one for me. I was introduced to the college game watching a Steve Logan game. I fell in love with his smooth criminal confidence and the way he sometimes locked his offhand in a downward position right before he fried you. For some reason, to me, it just looked like he had it loaded, waiting to attack. A great basketball player, great leader, and after further researching his story, seems like a great man. I'm proud to bring this feature to you, my first favorite college basketball player as a youngin', Steve Deontay Logan, born March 20th, 1980. Why wasn't he a future NBA All-Star? Here's three reasons. Salute to Robert Drake for this request. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth. Let's get it, man. Let's take a second to set this all up. Steve Logan was listed as high as 5'10". That's a very generous listing, I'd say. But in no way, shape, or form was his height a growth stunt in his career. This guy showed time and time again that no matter how big or athletic, you couldn't stop him. He literally had every single move that was around as a 90s guard. Leaving high school in Lakewood, Ohio in 1998, he was a Gatorade Player of the Year and state champion. He was a winner leaving high school, but for whatever reason, the winning didn't continue. Stunt number one, winning popularity and a little politics. Steve chose the University of Cincinnati, led by one of the greatest player coaches in Bob Huggins. In his freshman and sophomore seasons, he wasn't yet a standout, but one thing was clear from day one was that he was definitely their future. Let's fast forward for a sec. Steve Logan was a part of the 2002 NBA draft class. There were five point guards taken ahead of Steve. Besides Jay Williams and Juan Dixon, who won at high rates, with Juan even having a championship under his belt, there shouldn't have been any other point guards taken ahead of him in that class. Back to him entering his junior season. Logan was now the face of the Huggins-led Bearcats, along with future NBA player Kenny Satterfield. He took his team to first in Conference USA and the third round of the NCAA tournament before falling to Stanford. He averaged 17.6 points, shot 88% from the line, 39% from three, and an efficient 42% from the field. To put up those numbers at his height and position was extremely solid. Although Steve has played with a number of future NBA players, his teams never managed to win enough big games to give him that popularity you sometimes need to solidify your draft case. Guys like DeJuan Wagner, who came into college with that name, didn't have to do much and already considered better prospects than Logan. It's how the politics work at that level. At the end of the day, it's a business, and if they can use your name to market their product, it doesn't always matter who's better. In his senior season, Steve did manage to take his team to a conference championship, but lost in just the second round to UCLA in the NCAA tournament. Because he didn't show that at that size and dominant play style that he could win, it placed a strike of sorts on his name and allowed him to fall in the NBA draft. Stunt number two, first round debacle. I haven't seen anyone more affected by the first round, second round NBA rules more than Steve Logan. Logan remains one of the first few first-team All-Americans who has never been on an NBA roster and has yet to appear in an NBA game. Can you believe that? As a senior, Steve was an absolute assassin, man. He became the third leading scorer in school history and one of the best players in the country. His Bearcat team won the conference regular season title and tournament championship in his senior season. He averaged a scorching 22 points a game and 5 assists, all while once again shooting an amazing percentage. After, as earlier mentioned, losing to UCLA in the second round, he entered the 2002 NBA draft and was taken with the 30th pick by the Golden State Warriors. Some are thinking, well, that's great, he made it, good for him. Not so fast. That draft, the Minnesota Timberwolves were stripped of their first round pick, which landed a spot before Logan was selected. Because of the empty slot, Steve should have been considered a first-round pick in reality, being the 29th pick in that situation. But he lost that battle and kept his second-round pick status. This allowed the Warriors to bring him in and see how his game would translate and make a decision whether to keep him or not, seeing as they didn't have to offer him a guaranteed contract. they decided not to sign him, and his rights were traded away to the Mavericks, where he was waived. He wasn't even given the chance to show how intangible his game was in an actual game, and it's frustrating, but that's the game, and that became a huge play in his future. Stunt number 3, injury setbacks. After leaving the NBA scene before even really getting a chance to grab a coffee, Steve began his journey in 2006 playing overseas for a few years before tearing his meniscus. In 2011, in an interview, he explained that he hasn't played in 3 years while recovering from that injury, and sadly, that was the abrupt end to his career. I tell kids all the time, don't count your successes as an amateur as a lock to be the same successes in the NBA. There's so many hurdles and levels to it based on what name you have, winning, size, timing, need, and in Logan's case, simply where you're drafted. You couldn't tell me he wasn't better than Frank Williams or Dan Dickow, and even Juan Dixon, no disrespect. He just didn't have the same luck they had on draft night. Now, Jay Will was another story. That guy is still probably the best point guard I've seen in the 90s college basketball era. But Steve was deserving of a chance to show his worth in the league, and it just didn't happen. All in all, salute to him, man. If you see this video, just know that I appreciate you entertaining my early childhood and being an amazing role model you turned out to be. Salute, man. It's your boy JC Stunted Growth. I'm out.